Делаю видео по часу отрывками. Так, вот пошел второй отрывок сразу. Давайте двигаться к гостям.
I thought my chimney was big, but this one is beyond belief.
It's the least one can say. I've been longing for a warm fire for ages.
Since I set foot on the island, I haven't ventured more than 2 yards away from it.
Have you also just arrived?
Oh, late morning, I'd say.
Louis, come join us. Monsieur, may I introduce you to Monseigneur His Eminence, Cardinal Piaggi? He joins us straight from Rome.
Oh, just call me Your Eminence. It's simpler.
George Washington, President of the United States of America.
Delighted at last to make your acquaintance, Mr. President.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. President. Louis Maurras de Richer. It is an honor to meet you.
Young man, let's keep it simple, please. Let us forget our fancy titles. Nice to meet you, Louis.
I should imagine you never thought you'd be in such company.
I must admit that I didn't. It's the first time that I've ever met so many illustrious personalities.
And you haven't seen anything yet. Generally, when Lord Mortimer organizes one of his receptions, there are over a dozen people here.
They can't all be here yet. And you'll see, most of the time, there's only the upper crust.
And I noticed you were already getting to know His Eminence at the entrance. It's the perfect place to build up a network. What were you talking about, if you forgive my indiscretion?
Ну, о письме мы не будем говорить, потому что это вроде как секретно, так что остается один вариант.
At the risk of disappointing you, we weren't conspiring in our corner, sir. His Eminence was simply telling me that he knew my mother and how much he held her in high esteem.
It so happens that Monsieur de Riche's mother is to join us.
Oh, pity. No scrumptious gossip or juicy tidbits, unmentionable secrets, or even money matters. But you'll see, it will come. Despite all the goodwill in the world, you can't stop people scheming left and right around here.
Speak for yourself, sir.
Well, my friends, do any of you know the reason why we're here this time?
Not in the slightest. As for me, I've been invited by Sir Holm, a close friend of Lord Mortimer. But I do not know the reason why.
You see, Louis, every time Lord Mortimer organizes a reception, he always finds a moment to set up a chat with all the guests.
During which time we remake the world.
Accompanied by gallons of absinthe and cussing. I'll leave you to imagine the result.
So, if I understand rightly, Monsieur de Richer, you've come out here to join your mother. For what reason, exactly?
Я тут не помню, что выбирать. Копало это, получается, священник узнает.
Like you, Mr. President, I'm here as a result of Lord Mortimer's invitation.
Two members of the same family here. That is rare.
You know what they say. You can pick your nose, but you can't pick your family.
Seriously, though, I know your mother well. Stay behind with me afterwards, and we'll take a moment to speak about her.
Good Lord! Washington is wearing the emblem of the Grand Master of the Golden Order. It's the highest distinction of the order in the United States. It puts him on par with my mother. He must really know his stuff when it comes to the occult.
Good evening, my friends!
Holy shit! That's the man for my vision.
An urgent case has delayed our host, Lord Mortimer. He can't be present this evening, and he sends his deepest apologies.
He's asked me here and he hasn't even turned up? Great start. Do you know that man?
Sir Gregory Holm, an English aristocrat. Very influential. He's also close to Lord Mortimer. So don't be surprised if he acts like he's at home.
And now, my dear guests, a light meal is served in the small salon. For those who would like to, you're invited to follow me into the next room.
My dear fellow, you must have read my thoughts. I shall follow.
We'll have to be careful not to make too much noise. One of Lord Mortimer's guests is relaxing.
Oh, We shall be quiet.
Don't take it the wrong way, Sir Holm, but I have already eaten. Thus, I shall be happy to remain by the fireside.
If you don't mind, Gregory, I should like to keep Mr. Washington company.
Please feel at home. And you, sir?
If I stay with Washington, we'll be able to speak about my mother. But on the other hand, I'd like to learn more about this home. I saw him in my vision.
Сразу скажу, что и то, и другое пробовал, и вроде как с Вашингтоном я оставался меньшее количество раз из всех десятков раз, что я играл. Ну, так как здесь ничего нового, два этих персонажа стоят, с ними разговариваешь, и вроде как они оба, и вот эта баба Эмили, и Вашингтон, все они из Ордена, и, ну, есть несколько вариантов, либо всем доверять, либо никому не доверять. Выбирать, кому доверять, там кого-то, чьи-то стороны принимать. Пойдем поговорим с Холмом. Вот это тоже без толку, но поинтереснее. Ну и, не знаю, вариант, когда мы остаемся с Вашингтоном. С Вашингтоном можете пробовать играть там сами или смотреть что-то на Ютубе там. Переигрывать 1000 раз, это уже не будет смысла. Я буду проходить по самому лучшему, по моему мнению, пути по всем развилкам, которые больше опыта принесут.
My vision is more important. Let's follow home.
I'll follow you, sir. Mr. Washington, I hope to speak with you at greater length on another occasion. Emily, please excuse me, but I would like to speak to Sir Holm. I shall see you later.
My friend, I hope our dear Giovanni is well.
The troubles in France have fatigued him, but he will recover slowly. Do not fear. Yep. Apologizes for remaining in Rome.
Кстати говоря, у нас открылись персонажи, для которых можно прочитать. Про вот этих вот мы читали. Кардинал, Эмили, наш главный герой, Мортимер, ничего нету. Про слуг. Прочитаем про Вашингтона и про Холма, про вот этого. Фу, какой он уродливый, конечно. Так. Сэр Грегори Холм, барон Ноттингем. Влиятельный британский аристократ. Сэр Грегори защищает интересы британской короны, распространяя влияние Соединенного Королевства по всему миру и помогая уменьшить государственный долг. При его участии были приняты важнейшие экономические решения, от основания успешной Ост-Индской компании до размещения испанских торговых постов в Америке. Барон оказывает большую поддержку рабочему классу, открывая школы для бедных детей, которые, по его мнению, должны привести страну к новой промышленной революции. Сэр Грегори Холм никогда не упускает возможности познакомиться с новыми людьми на собраниях своего друга, лорда Уильяма Мортимера. Ну что, Вашингтон, Джордж Вашингтон, все слышали имя, это один из американских президентов, основатель и первый президент, вот еще даже первый президент Соединенных Штатов Америки. Жизнь Вашингтона была чередой военных и политических успехов. Много лет назад Сара Дериша познакомила его с верхушкой Золотого Ордена, влиятельного тайного общества Франции. Многим позднее Вашингтон возглавил Золотой Орден в Америке. Устав от политики, он хотел уйти на покой и встретить старость в своем поместье в Вирджинии, но лорд Мортимер уговорил его баллотироваться на второй срок. Вашингтон принял участие в выборах и вновь занял пост президента США. Получая приглашение от лорда Мортимера, Вашингтон обычно прибывает на собрание инкогнито. Но теперь что-то не инкогнито, ну ладно. Играем дальше.
The voyage was too much for him.
And right he was too. The mildness of the Mediterranean, eh? Come, sit down and have something to eat, my friend. You look rather pale. Excuse me, sir. I have been neglecting my duty. I haven't introduced myself. Sir Gregory Holm, an old friend of Lord Mortimer's.
A real pleasure, sir.
You who must be well used to the court of France. How do you find this peaceful little haven?
charming if I hadn't come here for disturbing reasons.
Yes, I heard the news. What a story.
Indeed. I wanted to ask you. You seem to know my mother well. Is that true?
Who does not know of her, sir? She has such a wide circle that everyone knows your mother from a distance or closer.
Everyone knows Sarah, my son.
But you only know her by her reputation.
I remember she once worked for the Crown of England and that she always honors her engagements. However, we have never been personally introduced, sir.
Well, if I'm to believe my vision, you're not going to get along with her. Thank you for your answers, Sir Holm. But I beg your pardon. I get the impression I know you. Have we met? Except in my dreams, of course.
Not that I remember, young man. Perhaps you are mistaking me for another member of the Chamber of Lords. And what with the wig and the powder, it wouldn't be the first time.
No, you were definitely the one I saw threatening my mother. I thought... Never mind. It'll come back to me. Would you allow me one last question, sir? I don't want to take up all your time.
Please, go ahead. What do you want to know?
Так. Ну, самое простое, зачем она приехала, наверное, ничего не скажет.
Do you know the reason for my mother's presence here?
I haven't the slightest idea, no. She was invited by Lord Mortimer.
But you don't know why?
Not really. I was given to understand that your mother was looking for something.
And do you know how long my mother and Lord Mortimer have known each other?
Several years, I believe. They seem to know each other for quite a while. But it was the first time that Lord Mortimer had invited her to join us here.
Good. And finally, would it be possible for me to speak with Lord Mortimer this evening?
I'm terribly sorry. No, he really is quite unavailable. But please rest assured that everyone is doing their best to find your mother.
All the same, it's not the Chateau de Versailles. It can't be that difficult to find her.
Worry not, my son. I am persuaded that we shall find the famous Sara de Riche. No doubt with new adventures to share, huh?
No!
Elizabeth! I should have insisted that you rest in your room.
Do you want me to call someone?
Let me handle this. I'm used to this kind of thing. Miss, can you hear me?
Leave me.
It's just a dizzy spell. Don't worry. You'll be all right. Her heart rate is already becoming more stable. Wow, poor girl's had her hands tattooed. I've seen these pinnacles before in old occult books from the end of the 12th century. I don't know what that young woman's trying to protect herself from, but she definitely takes it seriously.
I'm so sorry,
Can you tell me something about her? Who is this young lady?
Elizabeth Adams. She's come to the island for a course of treatment, to rest.
For a course of treatment?
That's right. The sea air can do wonders. Are you all right, Elizabeth? Do you feel any better?
When did she arrive?
4 days ago.
Okay. My mother had already gone missing. She's just regained consciousness and she immediately reaches for her brooch? I don't know exactly what it means to her, but obviously it's got to be something important.
Are you all right, Elizabeth? You gave us quite a fright.
Take it easy, miss.
Let me. I just need to get back to my room.
Of course, my dear. Go ahead.
You saw it, didn't you?
Pardon me?
Il segno della bestia.
Sorry, Your Eminence. I don't speak Italian.
Forget it. It doesn't matter.
Gentlemen, it's getting late. It is time for everyone to go to bed. It has been a long day.
It's all the more delicate.
I'll see what I can do, but the case I'm on at the moment might well leave me with very few opportunities. Well, I am impressed with all this splendor.
But don't spend too much time with Mr. Washington, my dear, or you'll lose your pretty accent. You seem to be intrigued by that statue.
Absolutely. It is remarkable.
Oh, it's naughty to tell lies. Bet my life that you were talking about something totally different from the decoration of the manor. But to find out what, I should have stayed with them. Too bad.
Lord Mortimer is fond of atypical works of art. I won't disguise the fact that I find it all a little megalomaniacal. But I must say, he does have some outstanding pieces.
Sir Holm, who was that young lady with you?
Elizabeth Adams, Mr. President. She would have liked to have stayed with us, but the poor thing is exhausted.
Elizabeth Adams?
Just mentioning Elizabeth totally changed Washington's attitude. Looks like he just saw a ghost.
Miss Adams is here to rest. You have perhaps already come across her in the corridors. She arrived a few days ago.
I perceived her, but we weren't introduced.
Rest assured, she is not here for the same reasons as yourselves. Consequently, I'm counting on your indulgence.
Washington looks surprised, but Holm doesn't seem to see it. I wonder if he's being polite or if he really doesn't see his discomfort.
On that note, it's very late. You must be exhausted. The servant will accompany you to your room.
Ladies, gentlemen, I bid you all good night. Mr. President, Your Eminence, Duchess, you have the same rooms as usual. You, Monsieur de Richet, will find your room at the end of the corridor.
Well, my friends, I am bone tired. I am off to my bed. See you in the morning.
Good night, sir. I shall do likewise.
Louis, I shall see you in the morning. Sleep well.
Good night. See you tomorrow.
Oh, man. It's been quite a day. Right. Where is my room?
Ну, самое главное — это пробежаться сейчас по всему этому коридору большому. Он опоясывает особняк вот таким большим квадратом. И найти все спрятанные вещи, монетки и так далее. И уже потом вернуться в комнату. Так что... начнем искать. Во. Так.
Duchess Emily Hillsborough.
Смотреть надо по всем закоулкам, потому что в каждом углу может лежать эта монетка на каждом стульчике.
Duke Manuel Godoy.
Godoya пока нету. Так, комната нашего главного героя.
Huh, that's me. Monseigneur, His Eminence Cardinal Piaggi. An old Cisterce from Roman Gaul.
Каждая монетка раскидана не просто так разработчиками, а для того, чтобы где-то знающий человек, который все монетки собирает, он получит больше опыта, больше навыков сможет прокачать. Ну, играть так или по-другому это уже выбор каждого.
President George Washington.
Будем проходить детально, полностью. Может быть, какие-то вещи упустим, но я постараюсь не упустить ничего. Казалось бы, кто мог подумать, да, сколько тут монет? Вон уже 8 штук. Так, а в журнале у нас тут еще появился, вот, Адамс. Дочь Джона Адамса, вице-президента США. Родители отказались от Элизабет, объявив ее мертворожденной. Девочка, которые воспитывали вдали от мира, выросла хрупкой и болезненной. С раннего детства Элизабет страдала от биполярного расстройства и приступов паники. Ей приходилось хранить столько страшных тайн, что это сказалось на ее рассудке. Девушку лечили множество докторов, но ничто не помогало. Элизабет постепенно сходила с ума. Наконец, Джон Адамс обратился к своим друзьям, сэру Грегори Холму и лорду Уильяму Мортимеру, надеясь, что на острове смогут ей помочь. Элизабет прибыла в особняк сравнительно недавно. Так, посмотрим дальше, что у нас тут монетки где лежат.
Monsieur Johann von Wulner.
Вот золотой эликсир.
A few leaves out of an old encyclopedia.
Энциклопедия — это типа манускрипта, только круче. Если читаешь энциклопедию, то сразу несколько навыков прокачивается, а манускрипт только какой-то один прокачивает, вроде как.
Decorum guide. Jacques Perru.
Вот уже почти вернулись вон там. Налево будет поворот и уже до нашей комнаты недалеко.
Monsieur Napoléon Bonaparte.
Даже Наполеон Бонапарт в этой игре есть, да. Последние закутки остались.
Duchess Emily Hillsborough.
Посмотрим еще тут. Не забыли ничего, надеюсь. Двигаться в комнатку. Вот вроде как полтора часа с начала игры прошло с объяснениями, и это только первый эпизод. У нас их три.
Right. So what shall I do with this letter? It might be about my mother's disappearance. But if I open it, I'll be betraying Piaggi's trust. What should I do?
Ну, будем играть хорошего мальчика, не будем открывать письмо, не будем подрывать доверие.
Damn, can't wait to open it, but I gave my word to Piaggi, so too bad. I'll wait until I hand it to mother. Wow, nice room. Mortimer sure doesn't do things halfway.
Самое интересное, что некоторые книжки могут быть находиться высоко, и для того, чтобы их достать, нужен навык ловкости. И вот спрятаны всякие склянки будут в всяких местах, всевозможных, за книжками и так далее.
Carmelite water. They say that if you drink this, it gives you a real boost. Saint Jerome and the Angel. Yet again, art with political undertones, with an image of a saint hearing voices.
Всякие картины. Вот взлома у нас нету, потом взломаем.
Inferno by Dante. Abandon hope, all ye who enter here. Lovely lectures Mortimer is giving to his guests. Very jolly.
Метка спрятанная. Вот.
Amber crystals.
То, о чем я и говорил. Прогуляемся за монетками. Там где-то кардинал должен находиться. Вот эта комната против как.
Honey, I couldn't have hoped for better. Carmelite water will give me a little reprieve.
Так, это в спальню, вход в нашу. Тут чисто видом полюбоваться. нас интересуют, конечно же, монетки. О. Ну вот здесь у нас итоги как бы как у каждой части перед началом следующей части игры. В каждом эпизоде там несколько частей перед началом показывают успех, неудача. Ну неудача, соответственно, меньше опыта будет, если больше вот таких категорий, как успех. Вошел в особняк, выяснил, там, нашел все зацепки и так далее, за всеми понаблюдал, со всеми пообщался. Будет больше очков опыта. Сейчас мы посмотрим, сколько нам дадут. Ну, развилки, соответственно, это те варианты, которые мы могли выбрать. То есть можно было остаться с Вашингтоном и с ним поговорить. Ну и ладно. Дальше смотрим, что у нас будет. Почти третий уровень. Чего-то не хватило там немножко. Скорее всего, со второй части, я как помню, будет третий и сразу четвертый уровень. Точнее, ну да, третий и четвертый. Два уровня будет. Вон предметы найдены, 1200. Прилично. Ну да, 4 очка дают. Вроде как не 3, 4. Хитрость. Ну и круче всего, конечно, будет прокачать два навыка сразу. Так, сюда один просто воткнуть, и уже будет два навыка. Сейчас вы можете выбрать, какой манускрипт будет читать ваш персонаж. После выполнения задания прочтенный манускрипт принесет вам дополнительные очки навыков. Ну, очень просто. Смотрим навыки. Смотрим, что нам потом будет проще вкачать. Если мы получим один навык этикета, например, надо будет два всего вкинуть очка сюда, и он будет прокачан. Или если выберем науку, надо будет один вкинуть и куда-нибудь еще три. Ну это выберем какой-нибудь. Ну, науку давайте выберем.
Your turn. The servants are not very efficient.
Durocher can't be far away. They'll find her soon. Their search time is restricted given that they must keep an eye on Adams.
I can take care of her, you know.
Yes. Well, in any case, I do thank you for bringing her to the island.
From what I've understood, the search of Durocher's room hasn't turned up any results.
Not yet, no. But we've put her son in there. Perhaps he'll find something.
That might come in handy.
Louis grows impatient at not yet having met the famous Lord Mortimer.
He will meet him tomorrow.
Oh, what a pity to lose a knight at the start of the game. Are you waiting for someone?
A young French soldier.
During our game of chess?
Don't worry, Gregory. The game won't disappear. I'll have one of my men escort you back.
Don't trouble yourself. I know my way out.
Ah, good evening, gentlemen. Please forgive me for this late hour.
It is never too late. And we have much to discuss. One last move?
Don't worry. Our games always seem to end like this.
Or always start like this. Come, come. Take a seat, my friend.
A little nighttime stroll, Mr. President?
There's nothing like it for a good night's sleep.
Do not hesitate to ask a servant to show you back.
The corridors seem quite safe.
Peppermint, lime flower, and valerian. My miracle remedy when one can't get to sleep. A very good night to you, Mr. President.
Thank you. And to you too, sir.
I'm coming.
Ну, собственно, это как доказательство того, что видение в данный момент происходило. То есть смотрит настоящее от лица какого-то другого человека, слуги в данном случае. Давайте прошаримся здесь. Ключ с кольцом. Что-то какой-то сундук, по-моему, в комнате стоит.
Dear Monsieur de Richet, please excuse me, but I am unable to join you at present. However, rest assured that we are doing all we can to resolve the case that concerns us. By the way, enclosed, you will find a key that will enable you to retrieve the personal effects your mother left behind. Yours faithfully, Lord William Mortimer.
Inspiration of Saint Matthew, or Matthew writing his gospel, dictated to him by voices. Incredulity of Saint Thomas. Why is Caravaggio representing Saint Thomas putting his finger in the wound? Thomas looks on but doesn't touch.
Вот этот сундук.
There's a circle around the lock here. Must be the trunk Mortimer was talking about. The key should open it. There's a note. Effects of Serre de Richet to be given to her son, Louis. I should probably take it. No space left. I'll retrieve it later.
Чтобы схавать мед, пятый, который лишний у нас, и взять тот, потратим очко действия.
Golden elixir.
эликсир, отлично.
Saint Jerome and the Angel.
All right, I've retrieved everything.
Excuse me, am I bothering you?
No, not in the least. Is something wrong?
I'm going to need your help. Do you remember the young lady we spoke of in the hall?
I bumped into her in the small salon before.
Well, she is the daughter of my friend, the Vice President, John Adams. But she is supposed to be dead.
Yeah, that's bizarre. Fair enough.
Good heavens! I was present at her funeral.
It is disturbing indeed.
Yes. I need to make sure it's her. That's where you come in. I want you to distract Elizabeth while I search her room. And perhaps get my hands on some important information. At least, I hope so. Elizabeth is in the small salon. If you hurry, you can still catch her. I just need 10 minutes.
But if my vision is true, there are two men nearby discussing very important issues, and one of them looks much like Mortimer. Washington is very kind, but I came to this island for my mother, not for his ghost stories.
Все правильно. Поэтому здесь выбирал я, кому учил Вашингтону, и ничего особенно интересного там нет. Вот видение проверить, вот это прикольно здесь. Самое лучшее время.
Sir, I don't feel well. I'm going to have to decline.
I see. Well, I hope you won't be needing my help one day.
I must act swiftly. I'll search my room later.
Ну и сейчас на данном этапе игры ограничивает наше передвижение по вот этой круговой, по этим коридорам. У нас есть только один вариант, куда сходить. Вот если сюда идти, сейчас вам скажу.
Луи, you're straying from your objective. Monseigneur, His Eminence Cardinal Piaggi.
Кстати говоря, может быть что-то добавляют какие-то предметы здесь, так что я не помню. Но на всякий случай смотри.
I recognize this part of the corridor. I'm close.
Так, поиск решения. Вы можете достичь цели разными способами. Тщательно обдумайте свое решение прежде. Перед тем, как сделать выбор.
Duchess Emily Hillsborough.
Как вариант, здесь комната, в которой находится наш вот этот Мортимер, находится с Наполеоном. Это вот эта ближняя комната, где слуга стоит. Дальше комната Жак Перу. И здесь комната Эмили. Из этой комнаты Эмили можно попасть на балкон и подслушать. И можно из комнаты Жака. Дело в том, что в комнате я вот не помню, можно ли выйти назад из комнаты Эмили. Там вроде какие-то вещи можно посмотреть, можно как-то попасться ей. Так, вроде как самая лучшая
часть. Good evening, sir. I'm sorry, but an important meeting is underway. My instructions are to let no one pass.
I see. So that's where it's happening, in that room. I've just got to find a way in there.
Где же больше предметов будет? Самый такой путь надо выбирать, и больше всего можно найти каких-то зацепок, улик.
I don't recognize anything in here. This must not be the room for my vision.
Но это комната Жак Перу. Надо все обыскать, все забрать.
A pattern with four circles. Dear Monsieur Peru, I'm writing to thank you for the funds you sent. These funds will be crucial for the renovation of the western wing of the orphanage. The children you sent are doing marvelously well, and little Pierre will soon be walking. Some of them still sometimes suffer nightmares about their parents on the scaffold, but I expect they will cease in due course. Should you decide to send us more, please note that another 20 beds will soon be ready. The children and myself will never thank you enough. Long live the Republic. Long live France. Sister Marie-Hélène. All right, I've retrieved everything.
Great, honey.
Так, где-то тут книга есть наверху. Нет, нету.
A letter, addressed to the French Revolutionary Court. He wants to show them his loyalty, and for that, he includes a list of guillotinable people.
Women, children, precautionary beheadings? This man would kill them all. This man's ruthless.
Да, по найденным предметам письма можно узнать слабость и устойчивость. Вот, кстати, балкон, если пройти сюда, если нажать, то сразу пойдет кат-сцена. Как бы возможность вот, посмотреть комнату, поискать, будет упущена. Поэтому лучше всего шариться как можно дольше. В чьих-то комнатах, которые позволяют.
Fine quality boots. Given the size of them, the man they belong to must be pretty big.
Dear friend, please come and join us. We must meet about the ongoing operations in Paris. A boat will be waiting for you in Calais, and we'll take you to Dover in England. From there, a carriage will take you to the port of Tintagel, where a frigate will be waiting for you and other guests, so you can meet up with me on my island as quickly as possible. I await your arrival, Lord William Mortimer.
Так, шаримся. О, вот. Золотой эликсир.
Records of the police. Notes intended for the police lieutenant of Paris.
It's a list of people under surveillance in Paris, and there's some well-known names on it.
This is valuable information. This shouldn't be lying around.
Вот, слабость психологии. Не самый лучший вариант, почему в эту комнату нужно идти, это то, что есть выход назад в коридор. Если честно, есть там два варианта.
Dear Monsieur, all right, I've retrieved everything.
Идти в комнату Элизабет, что единственная возможность, кстати, нам предоставится сейчас. Потом я не помню, будет ли она, ну, в этом первом эпизоде. А вот в комнату Наполеона мы точно попадем. И в комнате Наполеона будет доступна лишь первая часть комнаты, как здесь комнаты состоят из двух частей. Спальня и вот такая вот прихожая. А в комнате Элизабет будет доступна и та, и другая часть. и можно будет прошарить прям все там, все перерыть. Вот, а так как в комнату Наполеона мы попадем, а в комнату Элизабет нет, то сейчас лучший вариант — это пойти в комнату Элизабет. И еще попутно со слугой поговорить, отправить его куда-то, чтобы он ушел. Мы больше очков опыта заработаем.
Tell me, my good man.
Sir?
Так, напугать. Столько мы очков тратить не будем.
Listen, I'm an insomniac, and Sir Holm told me that you could go to the kitchen and make me a cup of herbal tea.
And what is in this herbal tea, sir?
Holm gave Washington a recipe for a sleeping draught. What was it again?
Мята, лиловый цвет, корень валерьяны, он говорил.
Peppermint, lime flower and valerian.
I... yes, it's herbal tea. I'll go and make it for you at once, sir.
I'll wait for you in my room.
I need to find a place to watch undisturbed.
Нет. Прохода назад нет. Ну, надо было не говорить. Какой это что? Ладно. Пускай будет так.
The Prince by Machiavelli. A perfect read for anyone with a surfeit of ambition. That might come in handy.
Устойчивость к политике Наполеона.
Honey, I couldn't have hoped for better. Honey, I couldn't have hoped for better. A bicorn decorated with a cockade. It must belong to a French soldier.
Сколько чего тут лежит?
Carmelite water. They say that if you drink this, it gives you a real boost. It's a beautiful weapon. Levy Damask blade. It's marked with the initials of the manufacturer in Versailles. My dearest son, I'm writing to implore you to act quickly. The situation is rapidly worsening here. Paoli continues to steer our motherland, Corsica, toward open warfare between France and England. His men are everywhere. We are obliged to go into hiding and are unable to remain in the same place for more than 2 days. I wouldn't be surprised if they targeted us soon. Make haste, my son. You hold our destiny in your hands. Your loving mother, Maria Letizia Bonaparte.
Письмо от матушки.
I can't hear anything here. I've got to find another spot.
Ну, соответственно, смысл ночной прогулки.
This window opens onto the balcony. Okay, so that means the other room must be on my right.
Sir, I understand your eagerness, but the pressure on my family complicates the task.
Relax, my friend. Your relatives will soon be safe.
So what I saw in my vision really did happen. Well, I hope I haven't missed anything important.
I thank you so much.
Don't mention it. Now that's settled, let us speak about your support.
Yes. You mentioned earlier some assistance from the Golden Order?
Absolutely. I have concluded an agreement with their leader, Lady Sarah Faustine de Richet.
Another case that Mother didn't tell me about.
The funds from the order will finance the building of a foundry in Tuscany. You will soon be able to count on 100 or more cannons for your future campaigns.
I was not expecting so much help from you. When can I meet this de Richer?
Well, unfortunately, something has cropped up. De Richer has disappeared.
Disappeared? What, here?
Yes, but the staff are redoubling efforts to find her, I assure you.
So the agreement, is it on or off?
It is on. Her right-hand man has just arrived here to help us find her. And it is none other than her son, Louis Moras de Richer. I wager he will ensure his mother's commitments are met.
Louis, not an easy name to live with in these times.
Of course. But from now on, you will deal with him.
This man, it can only be Mortimer.
Very well. I will seek him out.
Ma'am. That was a close call.
When you see Louis, speak to him about the amount of our agreement.
And how much exactly are we talking about?
20,000 louis d'or. A sum that will enable you to easily win your next conquests. My friend, an unparalleled destiny awaits you in France.
That is very flattering. However, is 20,000 louis d'or enough to purchase so many cannons?
In this case, yes. Madame de Richer and I have negotiated a very good price.
Very well. You can count on me to talk with her son.
Perfect. Remember that great things can be achieved with him on your side.
Of course. Anything else?
Not for now. Try to get some rest. The next few days are likely to be tiring.
Then, sir, I bid you a good evening.
Good evening, my friend.
It's time to leave.
Louis?
Emily? I can explain.
Perhaps, but remains...
Ну вот, такие вот типа растерянности, собеседник привел вас в смятение, применение навыков стоит дороже. Ну и мы с золотым эликсиром такие штуки снимаем.
Still.
But first, you could perhaps remove the blade from my throat?
You have 10 seconds to explain your presence here.
I'm not here for you.
What are you doing in my room?
First of all, let's keep calm. My being here is just a coincidence. Anyway, I seriously doubt what I'm doing in your room is really the question that interests you. Now, is it?
Clever boy. So answer the question that does interest me. What were you really doing on the balcony?
Seeing the window open, I feared someone had entered your room. With what I'd heard next door, I'd every reason to believe that your life was in danger.
I am a grown woman, but how kind of you to worry about me. Now that I'm safe and sound, tell me more. Has this anything to do with the order? Oh yes, Washington informed me you were part of the order.
You too? You're part of this too?
Yes. Now answer. Do these events concern me? Do they involve the Golden Order?
Ну, это будет не так важно, поэтому делимся.
I overheard a conversation between a French soldier and some other individual.
And what were they talking about?
It seems mother is involved, something about a military campaign. Apparently my mother validated an order of cannons to help this man.
Really? Since when does the Order finance wars?
As far as I know, since never.
Did they give any details, a date, what they were for?
Nothing at all. Did you know anything about this?
No, but I won't forget. Thank you. All right, Louis, I might have overreacted a bit.
Please do excuse me, but next time, please try knocking on my door. I'd be delighted to open it for you.
Oh, well, I'll remember in that case. Good night, Emily.
Good night, Louis.
Вот так вот. Надо было пошариться у нее в комнате.